Are you ready for the killer? Yeah. Are you ready for the killer?
Absolutely.
Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk? Dat kan een kik niet pikken. Dat kan een kik niet pikken, de jeuk. Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk? Dat kan een kik niet pikken. Dat kan een kik niet pikken, de jeuk. Is geen klappertje door, dat ken ik goed verstand. Dan rijd elke serieuze mengs al eens beoefde aan. Maar komt maar niet vertellen dat je heel de dag lang klapt. Wees hoe ver je schept, geef toe dat je mij uit ongepakt. En was het al hier wat smossen in een beetje tijdig en rust. Of het ook liggen vossen, schat, hoe ver ging dat je mus? Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk?
Hello, good morning. We are here with our radish. Tomorrow is Saturday, so we are preparing something for our market there in FTI. We will invite you to visit our stall there tomorrow. Yeah. Here, there is our radish. Oh, look at that one here. So beautiful. Not so much, but at least we have something to display there in the market tomorrow.
Yeah, it always tastes better when it's still not really that big.
Yes, this is the right size.
This one. Yeah, that's a bit small, but...
But that's okay, that's really the... That's, considering the time, it's also very hot.
Yeah, it was... it's hot and we did not really let them grow that long.
This is the right size.
Yeah. So it will...
There are several already, look at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, no,
you just scattered the seeds here and they just grew.
Oops. Better put this nicely there. Okay? Yeah.
All right. What are you doing?
I'm making a float. And the dog is going to help me.
Bobby Boucher.
What are you going here, eh?
Bobby, out.
I might paste your nose, eh?
No,
I make a float here for our duckweed.
Yeah. We're going to show you a bit later. We're going to let that float.
That float.
So it needs to be watertight.
Yes.
So Papa is putting a solvent to vulcanize both plastic tubes together. So it will create a really tight... bond, so that the water won't come in.
And then they will float on the water. We put the net under. Then we put our duckweed, so the fish cannot get at it.
All right.
Yeah.
So these are the white radish that Mama took, and a bit of jalapenos and one pickling cucumber because we already collected within the week. Because these vegetables have a very long storage life. And here we also have a bit of French beans we can add to our collection we already collected during the week. So we still have to do, harvest other things which we are going to include in this video. Look at our celery. What beauty. So Mama is cleaning them, taking out the old leaves, so they will be very presentable.
Yeah, you can see they are still very beautiful.
Yeah, considering that they're old plants, and Papa here is with his toy
Floating toy.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
All right.
Toys for the big boys, yeah?
Toys for the big boys. So this is the area, our nursery. As you can see, we already have, not sure if you can see them, small tilapias. So this is our nursery. So that's one. We have hundreds here, but they're a bit elusive. So this is where Papa is going to put the floating device so that we can again grow our own what do you call this? Duckweed and azolla. So we can feed the fish with that. Papa is going to put the net underneath so the fish won't eat all the azolla and duckweed before they're ready to be given to them. All right, let's see if we can. Where are all the fingerlings? They're so fast. There's another one there. We never run out of tilapia. So if you're going to raise fish, according to our experience, tilapia is like no maintenance. They produce or reproduce very fast.
This is our arugula. They suffered, you can see a little bit here.
Yeah,
they suffered from the heat also.
Yeah.
And at the same time.
But still, they look very
beautiful. But still, very nice. The smell. Yeah. The smell is really very beautiful.
It's you a bit see. Nutty.
Mm-hmm. And very, very crunchy.
Yeah.
Also.
So that will also be included at our FDI weekend market tomorrow.
Uh-huh. Let's try to make this thing float here.
Yeah.
And see how deep it goes, so we know what we have to do with our net under.
It's very buoyant.
Yes. Yeah, I think it goes up to a little less than half. Right?
Yeah, but I think you can still put the net just exactly
yes.
on it, because they still have a bit of space here.
Yeah, as long as the duckweed
has water
and grow on it, and the roots do not come out on the other side, that the fish will pull it out.
Yeah, but I think still, if it's pulled out by the fish, they will still continue growing.
Yeah,
as you can see here, we also reinforced.
See, you see here, that's the middle of it.
Yeah, that's the middle of it.
So until here, so there's still.
And when you do things, make sure that you don't have to do it twice. So what we did here is to add sealant outside, even though we already put solvent on it. So now it's floating really high. Something smells sweet here.
Yes, because we will also bring some red basil there for tomorrow.
Yeah.
Only a few here.
If only you guys were here. It really smells good.
And now, this one is a lemon basil.
Are you sure? Because sometimes
it really smells
it's lemon.
Like our
lemongrass. Yeah. So this kind of basil is good for tea.
Tea, yes.
Yeah. So there are also people there who are looking for their tea products. So we're going to bring them fresh basil.
Parsley here. We will also bring some parsley to FDI tomorrow.
Yeah. Actually, this is a very, very old parsley plant. We don't uproot it, just take out the stalks. Just make sure you don't damage the main plant.
Yeah.
Or it will die.
That was my mistake.
Yeah, before, but still it bounced back. It was not that damaged, so still we have parsley here.
Yes.
Alright.
Here are our lettuce. This is the red rabbit. You have to be very careful because they are very
crunchy.
Succulent and crunchy.
Brittle.
Still pretty elephants.
Are much awaited.
Oh my goodness, so beautiful. Besides the fact that it is too hot this time,
yeah.
But they are still, look at that. They yeah. grew.
And the leaves are still translucent.
Yes.
That's the most important thing, because yes. if it's too thick, it's going to taste bitter.
Yes. That's all right. Very nice.
So people, they are going to be excited when they see our red rapid lettuce. All right. So do you still remember, I think 2 or 3 episodes back, I think it was 2 episodes back, Papa dug trenches here and put seeds of white radish. So as you can see, the white radish now are getting high. So what we need to do is to earth them up. Like what we explained in the video 2 episodes back, we just put the trenches back in. So it will earth up your crops. You can do it by hand or you can use a tool, but I prefer using my hands. I have more control over everything.
Ah, you want to be in control, huh?
Yeah. I don't want to use an extension of my hand. On the side it's a bit shallow, but you can figure it out, turn them up. So I have to do the whole bed so that the plants will have a much, because these are root crops. So
there are a few that did not sprout here.
Yeah, but still
anyway,
we have a lot.
Yeah, oh yes, there are a lot that I put there.
So earth them up.
Wow, that's good,
so
eh?
It's going to cover the lower part.
Yeah.
Where the crop or the roots are going to develop into bigger ones. And we're going to we can harvest it to use it in our weekend market.
Okay.
Alright.
Now we are going to harvest our romaine. Oh, they really look good. Before we could never get them that well. It's because we have better nutrients now.
Yeah.
So we will harvest also tomorrow.
A much better system.
I just cut off the roots so that it's not difficult to clean. They don't become all dirty here in the basin.
And the roots can go straight to the compost pile.
Yeah, it's not a good Caesar, this one.
I think it's a bit of an old Caesar.
Yeah.
It's not that sharp anymore.
Maybe do it here, that's better.
Yeah.
No, they can't take all the ugly leaves there in the kitchen.
Yeah. All right, look how beautiful and closing they are.
Yes.
Wow. Bobby Boucher, what you doing here inside? Can I honk your nose? Honky bonky. Bobby Boucher, with your necktie. Can I see your necktie? You have a necktie, so you're going to a meeting, Bobby Boucher. Where's Wolfito? Wolfito! Chiquito. Wolfito, with your mother's eyes. And Bobby, we don't really know which traits of Banjo and Lucy you got, but for sure, you're a special dog. Couldn't contain yourself. All right.